There are few better places to experience nature's splendor than the Serengeti. Here, well-known creatures raise families next to others less celebrated. Competition can be fierce for territory, food, and rights to mate. Never-ending journeys are endured, beset with challenging obstacles. Water worlds boast stunning beauty and high drama. Here is nature in all her diversity, vigorous and unbound. In the vast continent of Africa, on its eastern shores, lies the country of Tanzania, a place where nature stakes her generous claim. Its epic wilderness areas are home to an astonishing cast of creatures based in the Serengeti ecosystem. In the wild, animals protect what's most important to them. The monitor lizard is partial to all kinds of eggs. Thickneys protect their nest from any hungry intruder. That's one reptile moved on. Another, not so easy to intimidate, even with a withering stare. Innocent vervet monkeys get the same treatment as the monitor. A Nile crocodile releases her babies. Her presence protects the young, which are vulnerable to cannibalism. Best to stay with mum as long as possible. Opportunistic Nile crocs think nothing of predating their neighbor's clutch. That is until the neighbor has something to say about that. An intruder will risk a mighty blow for the smallest mouthful. And then take out his frustration on the nearest cold body. Thompson Gazelle's defensive strategy relies on speed and confusion. A vulnerable fawn flees from an aggressive golden jackal. The The mother offers herself as a target. Intervention by the parent is designed to disorient and slow the predator down, so her fawn can disappear into the long grasses. The jackal is far enough away for the fawn to be safe. The protective parent strategy is not workable if the victim wanders too far into the lion's den. There may be trouble ahead, but the reaction is late and in the wrong direction. No strategy helps if you move too close to the predator. But it's now the lioness that needs to defend her catch from two unknown males. A rustle in the dry grass gives him away. She is submissive, but not about to leave her kill. Against two, she stands no chance. And at the first opportunity, she bolts. Specialists in the defense of their own kills are leopards. The big cat's first order of business is to drag the carcass to a known tree and devour it without interruption. Once stripped, the carcass is ejected from the tree or left hanging on lower branches. Defending your rightful catch is an oft-repeated drama on the Serengeti Plains. The first act involves a clean kill. This alerts the aerial waste brigade, the vultures, whose patience in the air is fleeting. exposed, the predator tries to relocate the kill. It's a long way to shade, and the party is just getting started. Act two begins with an action of mass bullying. No single predator can stay a tide of sharp beaks and claws. They can resist, but their defense has crumbled. Act three is the arrival of the one creature that even vultures make way for, the spotted hyena. Slim pickings, and even slimmer for those that missed out. In a Nile crocodile Mexican standoff, a mother lays between her offspring and a predatory male. Gravity delivers the first victim. There are many more, inches away from being devoured. The bank is steep. Each step invites a misstep. The hatchling is surely doomed. Its incredible luck is holding. The huge cannibal croc has a mouthful of mud for his efforts. But patience is a Nile crocodile's speciality. Another close call. But this time, Mum draws the defensive line. An agitated plover tells the jackal there is something worth defending nearby. A chick in the grass and a close encounter. Reinforcements encourage the predator to leave. At home with her brood, the Nile croc mother stands guard. The fish eagle waits for her to reach the water. Even submerged, she is vigilant. Sends a strong signal. Defending your young from predators is a parental duty. Defending them from nosy neighbors is also an obligation. The hippo means no harm, but a giant can still squash a two-week-old crocodile. Their mother encourages the visitor to back off. And if the message wasn't clear enough, golden jackals expecting their own offspring are no amateurs when it comes to defending their territory. While the male prepares a large burrow, the female attempts to get comfortable. Once the burrow is ready, the female will settle in to give birth. But what neither want in their territory at this vulnerable time is an animal with the fiercest reputation, the honey badger. Even lions will give this creature a wide berth. The honey badger represents a significant threat to an imminent litter, so the jackals escort it to the boundary of their territory. Having a place to call home is important to crocodiles. When the dry season grips the land and water is hard to come by, crocodiles must still find a way to cool off. Shelter is their only defense. These self-constructed croc caves are often inhabited by many individuals. When food is scarce and the reptiles find it hard to regulate their temperature, crocs can remain in a long dormant state known as aestivation until conditions improve. Having no practical home to defend but a home range, lone cheetahs have to let other cheetahs know. It's usually enough to scent mark the boundary. Showing subservience, the intruder moves off. A young mother with cubs will avoid a confrontation. There's too much at stake to risk injury. Near a small wildebeest herd, this cheetah is in coalition with two others. A small group of males has much more success hunting than a lone individual. A young wildebeest is singled out. His defense is spirited, but he's outnumbered. In such a confrontation, the cheetahs cannot use their principal weapons, speed and the strike of their dew claw. Surprisingly, the calf's self-defense is robust and it rejoins the herd. The great herd's endless journey continues with potential danger at all sides. When protecting your own life or the lives of the next generation. When securing territorial rights or protecting hard-earned resources. You earn your place in the beautiful Serengeti.